गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न पार्थिनोजेनेसिस। पार्थिनोजेनेसिस और वर्जिनल रिप्रोडक्शन इज ए स्पेशल टाइप ऑफ सेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन इन विच एन एग और द ओवम डेवलप्स विदाउट फर्टिलाइजेशन। इट इज जनरली एग्रीड दैट ए मैच्योर ओवम कॉन्टेंट within itself all the material potentiality to form a new being. The potentiality of the ovum to develop further without fertilization or by parthenogenesis either is released naturally in many invertebrates or can be released experimentally in many invertebrates and chordates by a variety of mechanical, chemical and physicochemical means. Williams and Warwick, 1980. Beatty, 1967, has defined a phenomenon of parthenogenesis as a development of female gametes into the embryo without any genetic contribution from the male gamete, without the attainment of the adulthood. The word parthenogenesis is a Greek word. Greek parthenos means virgin, a genesis means origin. Virgin, origin of an embryo, literally means birth of an individual from a virgin. The individual reproduction by parthenogenesis are called parthenotes. Parthenogenesis frequently occur in natural courses in certain orders of insects such as Hymenoptera, honeybee and wasp, Homeoptera, aphids, Coleoptera, beetles, rotifers and lower crustaceans, apes or the tadpole fish, Artemia or brine shrimp, Cypris and Daphnia, and certain desert lizard. However, it has been successfully induced artificially in echinoderms, mollusks, anadids, amphioras, and mammals. Thus, the parthenogenesis is of two main kinds: natural or spontaneous parthenogenesis, and artificial or induced parthenogenesis. Natural parthenogenesis. The parthenogenesis occurs in a nature phenomena in a number of species. In some organisms, it is usual, facultative, or exclusive obligatory mode of reproduction. Natural parthenogenesis fell into following two broad classes. First, complete parthenogenesis, and second is cyclic parthenogenesis. In the complete parthenogenesis, some platyhelminths, rotifers, and sundry wasps' parthenogenesis appears to be only form of reproduction, and this is called complete parthenogenesis. It is complete parthenogenesis. Every individual arises from an unfertilized egg. The species consists entirely of females, and male appears rarely, if at all. Sexuality is lost in this group. The entire adult life is devoted to breeding and reproduction. The advantage of this system lies in the population's high reproductive capabilities. Since each individual is a female producing more offspring, on the other hand, the system loses the advantage offered by the sexual recombination, which means that the only source of species variation is a mutation. Cyclic parthenogenesis. In a cyclic parthenogenesis, which is found in amphibians and some rotifers, several generations of parthenogenetic reproduction alternates with biparental reproduction in which egg is fertilized. Thus, cyclic parthenogenesis retains the advantage of sexuality. These groups are benefited from both methods of reproduction. Since parthenogenesis and bisexuality are found in an animal's life cycle, amphibians, for example, increase rapidity during the parthenogenetic portion of the life cycle. In a spring, egg hatches as a female, which invades plants and reproduces many parthenogenetic offspring through the summer months. Gene recombination is achieved in the single sexual generation at the end of the summer. eggs from some winged females become sexually individual, which mate. From these fertilized eggs, female nymphs emerge in the spring the following year to repeat the cycle. See Grant, 1978. This cycle we can see for the cyclic parthenogenesis. Here is gametes with n number of the chromosomes. This is another gametes with 2n minus 1 number of the chromosomes, which is the adult male, which releases a sperm. This sperm fused with the n number chromosome consisting zygote, ovum, and it forms zygote. This zygote consists of 2n number of the chromosomes, which is a female, and produces female with 2n number of the chromosomes. This female, she is diploid, and stem mother with diploid number of the chromosomes produces male and female producers with 2n, n plus n number of the chromosomes. 2n ovum parthenogenetic and 2n female with sexual forms. This cycle occurs during the cyclic parthenogenesis. Whole chromosomal composition can be presented here through the 2n, 4n, 2n, nn, 2n, and 2n, 2n. Cyclic diploid parthenogenesis in the amphibian, female emerging in the spring produces many generations of the females by diploid parthenogenesis. Resulting from suppression of the first or second polar body at the summer, end of the some female produces sexual males and females by diploid parthenogenesis. Male differing from females in lacking one sex chromosomes, both of these sexes in turn produce haploid gametes through normal meiosis, which fuses to form diploid zygotes that emerge again in the spring as a parthenogenetic females after Grant, 1978. Rotifers too have a curious type of reproduction. They are generally separate sexes. Female are of two types, amictic or mictic, and each produces separate type of eggs. Mictic eggs are haploid and can be fertilized by the male. A fertilized mictic egg becomes dormant and eventually develop into a diploid female. If a mictic egg are not fertilized, they develop into a haploid males. Amictic female produce diploid eggs, which develops directly into the diploid females without fertilization by the process of parthenogenesis. The relative proportion of these sexes, the presence of dormant eggs appear to be controlled both by internal physiology and environmental condition, but the nature of this relation is obscure. Dormant eggs tend to be produced when extreme condition of the temperature or drying prevails. The eggs can survive for the weeks or months in this state. Harriet, 2nd, 1977. Natural parthenogenesis has also been classified according to the following two ways, both of which are independent to each other. First, this classification of the natural parthenogenesis based on the behavior of the chromosome. Based on the behavior of the chromosomes during the meiosis, the following three types of natural parthenogenesis have been recognized. These are haploid, diploid parthenogenesis. In this, haploid parthenogenetic males and diploid females. In this case, normal meiosis occurs and parthenogenetic haploid develops into the males. For example, queen honeybee is fertilized only once by a male drone or sometimes by more than one drone. She stored the sperms in her seminal receptacle and she lays her eggs. She can either fertilize the eggs or allow them to pass unfertilized. The fertilized egg deployed with 32 chromosomes developed into females, queens or workers. The unfertilized eggs haploid with 16 chromosomes becomes male or drone. According to Grant 1978, in this case, only the germline remains haploid. Since all the somatic cells or the tissue, as is true for the many insects, become highly polyploid or polygenic during the larval development. The male produces normal gametes because meiosis does not occur to prevent the further reduction of the chromosome set. And each spermatogonium undergoes one mitotic division. This is the representation through the eggs, consists of diploid number of the chromosomes in honeybee queen, which produces n mature ovas through the meiosis. When egg are fertilized with the sperm, again 2N zygote is formed, and this 2N zygote female worker bee are produced. N number of ova, N number of zygote and N number of haploid species male are formed. This is oogonium with 2N, tetrad with 4N, first polar body 2N with ovum which consists of 2N, second meiotic division which consists of N plus N and 2N removal of the chromosomes, second polar body consisting of the N number of the chromosomes, and through the activation or fertilization it becomes NN first cleavage. Haploid parthenogenesis in the bees, the diploid queens bee lay haploid eggs after meiosis. Most are fertilized by the stored sperm as they pass out. They develop as diploid female worker. At certain times, some eggs emerge unfertilized, and this develop as a fertile haploid male, which mate with the another queen on a nuptial flight, and she starts the cycling again in a new hive. This mechanism of haploid parthenogenesis is shown below, in which oocyte completes a normal meiosis, but the haploid egg is activated without sperm and develop as a haploid male after Grant 1978. Without any crossing over, produces two haploid sperms. Meiosis is female, is normal. Second is diploid parthenogenesis, which is also known as automictic or meiotic. In this case, meiosis occurs, but the chromosome number is double diplosis, either before or after meiosis. In before Moraba and Orthopatera, and after Solenobia Lepidoptera meiosis. Diplosis may be takes place by the following two methods. Either it occurs by autofertilization or by the restitution. Autofertilization, during this most common mechanism, during the oogenesis, the first meiotic division is normal and produce a first polar body or the polocytes. However, the second part of the meiotic division, meiosis second, is suppressed, and the second polar body's nucleus fuses with the egg nucleus or nucleus of the ootid to produce the diploid cell. During the restitution, the insect of order Hymenoptera, Nemertis, Conesius, and Lepidoptera nuclear division or the karyokinesis of the meiosis first of the primary oocyte form a nucleus of the secondary oocyte and a nucleus of the first polocyte. However, this karyokinesis is not followed by the cytokinesis. The chromosome of the both daughter nuclei get arranged on the equator and proceeds for the second meiotic division to form a diploid ovum and a diploid polocytes. The diploid ovum develops into a parthenogenetic diploid individual. I repeat it once again. In the insect order of the Hymenoptera and Lepidoptera, nuclear division of the karyokinensis and meiosis first of the primary oocytes forms a nucleus of the secondary oocyte and a nucleus of the first polocyte. However, this karyokinensis is not followed by the cytokinensis. The chromosomes of the both daughter nuclei get arranged on the equator and proceeds for the second meiotic division to form a diploid oocyte ovum and a diploid polocyte. The diploid ovum develops into a parthenogenetic diploid individual. Third is ameiotic parthenogenesis or apomeiotic parthenogenesis. In these cases, no meiosis occurs. Apomeiosis means meiosis that is either suppressed or imperfect. For example, in Brian's shrimp, Artemia salina, meiosis is entirely suppressed in the female, the maturation division of the eggs being entirely mitotic or equational in character. Likewise, in Trichoniscus isopoda, Daphnia pollex of the crustacea, or Camplinona rufum of the mollusca, weevils and long-horned grasshopper during oogenesis, the first meiotic division is completely suppressed and the primary oocyte directly undergoes a second maturation division, meiosis second. Consequently, such ova, eggs contain diploid number of the chromosomes and develop into the new individual without fertilization. Now we come to the classification of the natural parthenogenesis based on the sex of the offspring. Based on the sex of the offspring, there are the following types of the parthenogenesis. First, arenotoki, where only parthenogenesis male are produced, i.e. honeybee. Some other well-known examples of the arenotoki are the following. Hymenoptera insect shows arenotoki from primitive sawflies to the most specialized parasite and social wasps. In parasitic wasps, Hebrobrachon, the males are haploid having 10 number of chromosomes while the females have 20 number of the chromosomes since they are diploid. In these insects, femaleness is determined by heterozygosity at a number of the different loci on the several chromosomes. Haploid individual that is hatched from the unfertilized egg cannot heterozygous. Hence, they are male. Burus and Botino, 1989. In Coleoptera, Macromalthus debilis makes the haploid and develop from unfertilized egg. In Thysanoptera, Arthrothrips verbosi and Frank Liniella insulensis virgin female produce all haploid males. Some embryologists have questions the validity of this cast. The rotifera of Asplenchna amphora is an example of arenotoki where the males are the dwarf and develop from the haploid eggs. In another rotifers, Doloidea, males are unknown and arenotoki is the only mode of the reproduction. In Arachnida, arenotoki is mostly found in ticks and mites. In them, males are haploid and develop from the unfertilized egg, where the females are the diploid and sexual. Sarita 1923 have reported male haploidy in the mite Tetanrhynchus, and Patau 93 have described the male haploidy in the Pediculoides ventriconus. Thalitoki, the second one, in this case only parthenogenetic females are produced. In Thalitoki, the reductional division is abortive and a young individual develops from the unfertilized diploid egg. It includes the already discussed categories of the parthenogenesis such as meiotic एंड एमियोटिक पार्थिनोजेनेसिस। सोलेनोबिया, टिन्नस, लेंसर्टा सेक्सिकोला अमेरिकाना, नो मेल्स एक्जिस्ट इन द नेचर ऑफ दिस स्पीसीज एंड इट्स पॉपुलेशन इज प्रोपगेटेड एक्सक्लूसिवली बाई पार्थिनोजेनेटिक फीमेल्स। बैलेंस के 1991। एम्पिटोकी, इन दिस केसेस पार्थिनोजेनेसिस एक मे प्रोड्यूस इंडिविजुअल और आइदर सेक्स एफिस। आर्टिफिशियल पार्थिनोजेनेसिस, द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ द राइप एग आफ्टर द सर्टिन ट्रीटमेंट बट विदाउट फर्टिलाइजेशन इज कॉल्ड आर्टिफिशियल पार्थिनोजेनेसिस। द स्टडी ऑफ आर्टिफिशियल पार्थिनोजेनेसिस ऑफ द इंटरेस्ट बिकॉज इट थ्रो लाइट ऑन द एक्टिवेशन ऑफ द एग्स बाय द स्पर्म एट द टाइम ऑफ फर्टिलाइजेशन। एग्स ऑफ मेनी एनिमल्स सच एज सी अर्चिन, स्टार फिश, मॉथ, फिश फ्रॉग, टर्की, हैन, रैबिट एक्सेट्रा हैव बीन एक्टिवेटेड बाय द फॉलोइंग वेज एंड इट हैज़ बीन फाउंड दैट एग्स विच हैव बीन इंड्यूस्ड बाय आर्टिफिशियल मीन्स सेल्डम रीच मैच्योरिटी एंड सेल्डम डेवलप्स इनटू द इंडिविजुअल एडल्ट्स। केमिकल ट्रीटमेंट विथ हाइपो एंड हाइपरटोनिक सॉल्यूशन, वीक ऑर्गेनिक एसिड, ब्यूटारिक, ओलिक, लैक्टिक एसिड, एल्केलाइज 0.01 NnH3, क्लोराइड साल्ट्स ऑफ द लिथियम, सोडियम, पोटेशियम, कैल्शियम, मैग्नीशियम, स्ट्राइकनिन एंड एल्केलॉइड ऑब्टेन फ्रॉम द प्राइमरी फॉर्म दैट प्लांट नुक्स वॉमिका और स्ट्राइकनोस नक्स वॉमिका, फैट सॉल्वेंट्स, टोलुइन, ईथर, एल्कोहल, बेंजीन एंड एसीटोन एंड अदर केमिकल्स सच एज क्लोरोफॉर्म, यूरिया, सुक्रोज एंड कोरोसिव सप्लीमेंट एसेट्रा। ट्रीटमेंट विथ फिजिकल एजेंट्स सच एज हीट, कोल्ड शॉक व्हेन द एग इज ट्रांसपोर्ट फ्रॉम 30° टू -10°, इलेक्ट्रिक शॉक, शेकिंग एंड प्रिंकिंग। ट्रीटमेंट विथ द रेडिएशन सच एज फर्टिलाइजेशन इज जेनेटिकली इनएक्टिवेटेड अल्ट्रावोलेट और यूवी ट्रीटेड स्पर्म। मोड ऑफ एक्शन ऑफ द एजेंट ऑफ आर्टिफिशियल पार्थिनोजेनेसिस, द डाइवर्सिटी ऑफ द फिजिको केमिकल एजेंट्स इंड्यूसिंग पार्थिनोजेनेसिस ऑब्सक्यूर द अंडरलिंग एक्टिवेशन मैकेनिज्म। द वन कॉमन फीचर इज दैट ऑल एजेंट्स फर्स्ट एक्ट ऑन द एग प्लाज्मा मेम्ब्रेन विच बिहेव्स लाइक ए कोल्ड स्प्रिंग रेडी टू ट्रिगर इन टू द एक्शन एट द स्लाइटेस्ट स्टिमुलस। वंस द एग इज एक्टिवेटेड ए डेवलपमेंटल प्रोग्राम कैन बी अनफोल्ड और इन द एब्सेंस ऑफ स्पर्म सब लिथल डैमेज टू द एग कॉर्टेक्स, कैल्शियम आयन एंड पीएच चेंजेस अपीयर टू हैव रोल इन द एक्टिवेशन ऑफ द एग्वर्म टू फॉलो द एक्शन ऑफ द सम ऑफ द एक्टिविटी फैक्टर आर्टिफिशियल पार्थिनोजेनेसिस। लेट अस कंसिडर द फॉलोइंग क्लासिकल एक्सपेरिमेंट। फर्स्ट, आर्टिफिशियल पार्थिनोजेनेसिस इन सी अर्चिन, लोब्स 1913, वॉज वर्किंग ऑन द सी अर्चिन एग एंड डिस्कवर्ड दैट दे अंडरगो एक्टिवेशन व्हेन दे आर ट्रीटेड विथ हाइपरटोनिक सी वाटर। द फर्टिलाइजेशन मेम्ब्रेन इज एलिवेटेड इन द नॉर्मल फैशन बट ओनली सिंगल एस्टर मोनोएस्टर ऑफ कोर्स ऑफ मैटरनल ओरिजिन कैन फॉर्म। एट बेस्ट द क्रोमोसोम्स कैन अंडरगो ए फ्यू साइकिल्स ऑफ द रेप्लिकेशन अराउंड दिस मोनोएस्टर सिंस देयर इज ओनली वन एस्टर, नो टिपिकल माइटोटिक एपरेटस विथ टू एस्टर्स एंड ए स्पिंडल कैन फॉर्म। द कॉन्सिक्वेंसेज इज द एग कैन नॉट डिवाइड एंड विल नॉट डेवलप फर्दर बट लो फाउंड दैट if the activated eggs are submitted either a few minutes to a second treatment with the butyric acid and this time a second ester will appear and egg will develop parthenogenetically until the pupatus larva stage is reached. Artificial parthenogenesis in frog, Bataillon 1910 worked on a frog egg and found that they can be activated by pricking them with a clean fine glass needle. They form a fertilization membrane and undergoes a series of monoester abortive division cycles to a result of polyploidy. If, however, the needle is not clean,
and it is smeared with freshly drawn frog blood, so that a nucleate cell is introduced into the egg at the time of the pricking. A second ester will form around the injected cell and mitosis will then be normal and developed with proceed until the tadpole state, Bratcher 1974. The cell which has been introduced into the fertilized eggs thus contain a second factor necessary for the formation of the second ester and the further development. Since the introduction of a nucleate mammalian red blood cells had no effect, Bataillon concluded the second factor must somehow be linked to the cell nucleus and that a karyocatalysis is required for the parthenogenetic development. The chemical nature of second factor of the parthenogenesis is not yet known with certainty. Recent work has shown that it is not located in the nucleus but in cytoplasm, and most probably it is the either central mitochondria or the calcium ion. Further, it is important to note that parthenogenesis activation, even if it is not followed by the further development, it induces the same metabolic changes in the egg as fertilization. Treatment with hypertonic seawater, even in the absence of the second treatment with butyric acid, is sufficient to increase both the respiration and protein synthesis in the sea urchin. Thus, part played by the spermatozoa in these metabolic events appear to be negligible. Haploid syndrome. Parthenogenetically, embryos are, as a rule, haploid and die during the development. This is called haploid syndrome. I repeat it again. Parthenogenetically, embryos are, as a rule, haploid and die during the development. This is called haploid syndrome, Bratcher 1974. The haploid syndrome can very easily be demonstrated in the frog eggs, which have been fertilized with the sperm previously irradiated for a short time, 1 to 2 months, with the ultraviolet lamp. The spermatozoa remain perfectly motile, and the same percentage of fertilization can be obtained as with the normal irradiated sperm. But the chromatin of the spermatozoa have been irreversibly damaged, and the parental chromosomes are eliminated into the cytoplasm, where the DNA undergoes complete degradation during the first cleavage of the egg. The development in a first normal but a few eggs already failed to gastrulate. Properly, the others may reach at the best a very abnormal tadpole stage. Such tadpole exhibits strong oedema and excessive accumulation of the fluid in the cells, tissue spaces and body cavities due to the disturbances in the fluid exchange mechanism. I repeat it once again. Oedema and excessive accumulation of fluid in the cells, tissue spaces or body cavities due to the disturbances in the fluid exchange mechanism. And they have a reduced head, very small gills, are unable to digest their yolk completely. The haploid syndrome is always lethal. A few eggs, however, may escape death and become adults. Cytological observation shows they are always diploid, or the polyploid 4, 6 and 8 n. And this regulation of the number of the chromosomes is due to the fact that in a few eggs, the chromosomes undergo one or more monoester cycles of the replication before the second ester forms around the injected nucleated cells. Artificial parthenogenesis by ionophores. Certain compounds called calcium ionophores can activate, cause parthenogenetic development. The eggs of the white group of the animals, including sea urchins, tunicates, mollusks, amphibians, and mammals, stain Hart and Ipel 1974 and Ipel 1977. Ionophore makes cellular membrane permeable to the certain ions, and not only the other cells or the plasma membranes but internal membrane as well. Thus the calcium ion force facilitate the release and flow of the bound intracellular calcium in the sea urchin eggs, which is followed by immediately by the action potential of the fertilization. Cortical granules breakdown, membrane elevation and stimulation of the metabolism. However, the activated egg does not cleave. The experiment thus proves that the parthenogenetic agents may act by release in calcium. A case of egg squeezing in Habrobrachon. In the vas Habrobrachon, egg activation seems to result from mechanical stimulus imparted to the eggs, and it is squeezed through the ovipositor during the laying. Eggs protected from the compression process do not develop. Grant 1978. Artificial parthenogenesis in birds. Parthenogenesis can occur accidentally in many organisms by the suppression of the polar body formation in the meiosis, and this has been reported in domestic turkey, domestic hens, eggs laid by the female turkey which had been isolated from male start developing in the very high percentage of the cases, up to 41.7% in the experiment conducted by Olsen in 1960. Although there is still a high percentage of the abnormal development, a small number of the embryo reaches the hatching stage, and all the polluts were males, a few of these reached maturity and one was used with the success to fertilize eggs of the normal male. More recently, Cervella 1973, similar results have been obtained with the hens. Artificial parthenogenesis among mammals. Artificial parthenogenesis had been successfully induced in the eggs of the rabbits by Pincus 1936. It was found that the eggs of the rabbit are simply kept for up to 48 hours in the ordinary tissue culture medium, blood plasma plus the embryo extract. Some of them become activated and they complete their maturation, division, produce polar bodies, and even to create balanced in 1991. Significance of the parthenogenesis. Parthenogenesis has the following advantages and disadvantages. Advantages of the parthenogenesis. The process of parthenogenesis has the following advantages. First, parthenogenesis is a well-established mean of reproduction, and it is even simpler and easier than the sexual reproduction. Parthenogenesis represents a device of high multiplication. For example, amphibians multiply very fast during their parthenogenetic phase of the life cycle. Parthenogenesis permits the establishment of the triploid 3N and aneuploid races having three or more sets of the chromosomes. In triploid forms, three sets of the chromosomes fail to pair during the meiosis at the time of the gamete formation, thus the retardation of the formation of the gamete, and this leads to the sexual sterility. The parthenogenesis is thus a means of the aneuploid and individual to propagate their own kind. It has been described by Darlington 1939 as an escape from sterility. Parthenogenesis encourages advantageous combination of the characters of the genes originated by the mutation to remain in such, because these are not liable to segregate by the crossing over as there is no meiosis. Since all the mutagenic changes, their combinations are not useful to organisms, so the natural selection in the form of parthenogenesis tends to eliminate male adaptive combination of the genes. Parthenogenesis is a means of the sexual sex determination in honeybee and other animals. It supports the chromosomal theory of sexual determination. Parthenogenesis eliminates the need for mating and allows the whole energy of the adult's life to be devoted to feeding and reproduction. And finally, the evolution of parthenogenesis could have eliminated the need for an activation signal. As eggs mature in ovary, they might develop immediately without going into a metabolically arrest state. Except for its genetic and second factor contribution, the importance of the sperm embryogenesis is relatively minor. The egg alone is repository of the developmental information and can express this potential when stimulated by sperm or by some artificial agents. Disadvantage of the parthenogenesis. The main evolutionary disadvantage of the parthenogenesis is that it tends to eliminate variation in the population. The offspring developing parthenogenetically are more alike to and mostly the phenocopies of the parents, whereas a sexually developed offspring exhibit marked differences from the parents. Revision questions. Write short notes on the parthenogenesis. What is parthenogenesis? Explain how various methods of induced parthenogenesis help us in understanding the mechanism of fertilization. Describe the advantage and disadvantage of the parthenogenesis. Differentiate between the following: sexual development and parthenogenesis, arenotoki and thalitoki, natural and induced parthenogenesis, complete parthenogenesis and cyclic parthenogenesis. Write short notes on the haploid syndrome and ionophores. This is all about the parthenogenesis. We hope that this video becomes useful for my dear students of the various classes where it is prescribed in their syllabi. Okay, thank you for watching this video and have a good day.